going up to 3. But yeah, a lot of people have this sentiment where if things are going to suck for a while, then they'd rather end it quickly. Oh, this is very reminiscent of the elevator you take up to the dragon area in Dark Souls 2, which I'm thinking of right now because I just did that like last time I played Dark Souls 2. That'll probably be up by now, by the time this goes up, or soon, but... No, actually, this will probably come up sooner, because this is a daily series, but hey, Dark Souls 2 is coming back, very least. I don't abandon my shows, generally. So, Elohim has offered me a deal, pearly gates and eternal life, on the condition I turn back from the tower. I don't know what to do. Keep going up the tower. Fuck Elohim, he doesn't matter. Those are a lot of very straight beams that I'm just gonna stick in there real quick, don't mind me. Guess who still doesn't have a strategy? This guy. Worked out last time though, surprisingly enough. I don't buy into Elohim's promises to begin with very much in this game because of the fact that we are in many ways already immortal slash not alive in the first place. So it's harder to figure out the value of his promises at that point. Uh-oh, I'm in that situation where it's like, oh, there's one spot left and it's shaped like a piece that I don't have. Time to restart. We'll put in the weird, complicated pieces first and see if that helps a bit. Let's see. I want to put these in if I can because they're the more awkward ones to piece. There we go. Progress. This is not going to work. This is not going to work at all. Oh no. I'm so bad at these. I'm going to have to jump cut probably because these never go well for me. Oh no. Yep, that's what's happening. Hey, this is cool. I created a little symmetrical pattern and it's totally working. Ta-da! That was relatively quick. It seriously only took me like one or two extra attempts after I stopped showing you guys, and that was it. Alright, another audio recording.
I look in the mirror sometimes and I see myself like some alien being. I think, who am I? Why do I have these eyes and those hands? Why do I see the colors that I see? Why do I think like I think? I did not choose to exist. I was created. Every single part of my body, every strand of my DNA, is part of a story that stretches back billions of years. I exist only because of the choices and sacrifices made by so many others, but I don't know who they are. And what effect will my choices have on those who come after me? Maybe that's what it means to be human. Every species is part of the story, but we're the only ones who know that.
So this seems like a pretty easy puzzle so far, although I might be about to trap myself in here. Should be a bummer. Oh, there's another one. Shit. Okay, this is a little harder then. So... Huh. Oh, I get it. Record. Wait a bit for my future me. Turn around. Ta-da! Now future me runs in and finishes it. It finishes this and it's over. Just need to play it back now. And wait. I do enjoy the sentiment of what was just being discussed, though, the idea of, like, why do I have these hands? So how did this turn out this way? Every now and then, I do get the same feeling of, like, looking at humans as a concept of, like, how did we end up this way? And, like, how would someone outside perceive this? Like, I think we had, I was listening to the Rooster Teeth podcast, actually, and they talked about the idea of, like, how would humans look to a blind person, for example, if they just suddenly regained sight, or not regained, but gained sight for the first time after like 40 years. Like, what did humans look like then? How shocking would it be to see a human at that point? If this has all been a test, then I can expect a reckoning at the top. Yet the higher I climb, the more I doubt the decisions I've made. Sheep. I see now that none of us are yet ready. The cycle exists so that we may improve ourselves, but the one who reaches the summit is not our superior, for they stand on our shoulders to reach it. Shepherd. That's Shepherd being aware of the fact that we're AI that are all, we're a bunch of AI that are specifically what do you call it? Iterating? Yeah, iterating on each other. So one of us goes, we fail, we're scrapped, we're replaced by a slightly changed version, and see how if that one gets further. It's like creating an automated car that you try to have do a course, and every time it fucks up, you just tweak it a little bit, and you keep trying again until it finally works. And that all those are iterations. It's also when you make a yearly Call of Duty game. So, we should already be able to activate the next floor. I'm surprised how fast this was going. I had two scenarios in my head. Either A, you go in the tower and basically nothing happens, but that seemed... The more sigils I got that seemed to point to nothing, the more I was convinced there's gonna be puzzles up here. But now I'm surprised by how, each floor just has one puzzle. There's not like a chamber full of puzzles. So, do floor access control? Right, it needs a code. And this time the code's not just hanging out, so I think the obvious thing will be to, We should look at these texts. Oh, Osiris password. We'll check that one. We'll check the other ones too. We need to see if any of these have passwords in them. So, looking for numbers. This is where things could get difficult. Okay, so. And there in the tower, you shall hear the rustling of the wind and in the reed fields of Osiris, and you shall rejoice, but beware, for the end of your journey is not yet upon you. Thank you for installing Realistic Elevators 1.8. New features include password locking and automatic auxiliary stair generation. See? And the scribe of Osiris wrote upon the sacred parchment that it is called ANI Floor 4 Password 105. Only thus you can reach the blessed Aru. So, password is 105. That was pretty easy. And that's like, oops, my bad. That was a very corrupted looking, that seemed like a very corrupted, instruction manual. Where's a weird mixture of, like, weird mixture of mythology and storytelling and also just, like, a product description. It was an odd thing for it to be into. So, we should be able to unlock floor 4. Was it 105? I really hope I didn't already forget. I'm bad with numbers. Come on. Yeah, code accepted. All right. Floor 4, F6 unlocked. So, wow, we're halfway through the 6 floors already. I'm actually a little bit disappointed. I don't want this game to end that quickly. Although I do have to do a lot of star hunting, so that'll slow me down. Oh my god, that's a lot of hex. Without contraries, there is no progression. Attraction and repulsion, reason and energy, love and hate, are necessary to human existence. From these contraries spring what the religious call good and evil. Good is the passive that obeys reason. Evil is the active, springing from energy. Let's see. Religions call good and evil. Good obeys reason. Evil springs from energy. I don't know. Oftentimes, reason almost seems in contradiction with the religious definition of good to some extent, but who knows? You can argue this to the end of the earth, and people have. Chapter 14, the judgment of Hephaestus. These are the different chapters of the Athena book we've seen evidence of earlier. So, if what you say is true, and my father Hephaestus is slain, then who am I? For I was made in his image, and that image is now gone. Am I like the reflection in a mirror to vanish when the person steps away? Or have I now become Hephaestus myself, forged to be no more than a replacement, as one may purchase a new sandal from the same shoemaker? His legacy is... And that's it. I really wish we could talk to the serpent again. It's been a while. But anyway, that was actually the concept of iterating right there, being repeated back to us again, is the idea of like... That's more like, well, that's kind of a mythological concept there, but in practice, it's like human iteration. People create children that are literally in their own image. It's a mixture of two people in their own visual appearance. You can't even see the floor now, can you? It's just white outside. We're above the clouds. People create other people in their own image at some point, and from there, let's move these so they're not in my way as much. There we go. Oh, it's floating on its side. I feel like it's gonna fall out of the elevator somehow. But yeah, people create other people in their own images, and such is what children are. And that's almost like its own form of iteration for, oh my god, why? But yeah, that's basically human iteration, which I've already said, but whatever. I repeat myself sometimes when I'm trying to process multiple things at once. Which is what I do all the time in this game. So, this is going to be... I'm just going to start over already. So first things first, let's put down some of these weird Z shapes, because those are always the most difficult to manage. I've created a gap, so we'll put that there. Just because I happened to make something that was shaped like another one of the weird pieces. I just put that down so I wouldn't have to move it back all the way. I don't have much confidence in my ability to solve these puzzles. I'm already in trouble. I am in deep shit talky. Okay, so I can put that in, I can put that in, and now I'm fucked. So this is gonna take a few times. I'll see you guys in a bit, I'm pretty sure. We got it, finally. Holy shit, I do not like these puzzles. Progress, opening my giant mechanical bolt door. Yeah! So, my issue with these puzzles in my head is that I figure... By the way, man, those reds go away fast. I'm down to 14 now when I had like close to 50 earlier, I think. It's kind of disappointing to see them all disappear, actually, because you feel good about how many you have. But this is it. Oh god, you know what that means, right? I'm pretty sure that means that when I get to floor 5, it's going to be a 14-piece puzzle, and it's going to drive me absolutely insane. Because I'm going to use the... I must have to use the white ones to do the 6th floor. I'm not a fan of those puzzles specifically because... Well, look how far up I am, too. When I'm done with the 5th floor, I might have to just jump down. Just to see what it's like to jump down. Because I have to go back and... Oh, you can see how tall the tower is from there, because there's a shadow. Wow. Couldn't see that as well from up there. I may have to see if I can jump down when I'm done. For now, I want to see if those connectors will still come in handy at some point, potentially. Probably not. So I guess no one got this far before? I know some of my answers were wrong now. I just don't know which ones. I have these theories and wild explanations, but I don't know which to bank on. Sheep. The solution to the cycle isn't the perfection of one being, but the product of a mass endeavor. That is why I say to all those who come after me, I await you on the summit of the tower and use what I have learned to assist you as I can. Shepherd. Shepherd seems to be the most useful person around here. Definitely as you proceed through this whole world, the Shepherd's been the most balanced character so far. Everyone's having failures or emotional breaks. I think Shepherd's the only person I can think of that... I think almost all the other characters have died at some point and been iterated upon, but I don't remember the Shepherd ever failing and having to start over and being, you know, being terminated and replaced. Interesting. Okay.
There are flaws in the system. I think sometimes it accesses the wrong databases, pulls random data. I don't know how bad it is. It all seems to be stable, but I can't tell what kind of impact this is going to have on the process, and I just don't have the strength to go over all of the code again. I just don't want it all to be for nothing. I spent all my time here. I didn't visit my parents. I didn't see my friends. I did nothing but work. And I'm so scared that it didn't mean anything. That I just wasted it all because I thought we could... we could save the world.
So now Alexandra's having an emotional break because she just discovered the flaw that may be the exact thing that has caused this the game to crack up to this point. Because we know that everything degraded over time, and it may be because of that specific flaw we're talking about there. Is that a bouncy spot? Yeah. So she just discovered that, and she dedicated all of her remaining time to this specific problem. So the idea that it didn't work out is devastating to her. There's like a map on top of that. Can I see it in first person? What is that? Can't see it very well. What is that? Looks like it's just some kind of map. Probably not particularly important. Okay, so... obviously we need the keys to proceed. And the keys are behind a wall, which causes us some problems here. So the question is... If I put a block here in this spot, and I stand here with this, could another person standing on top of a block reach those keys? I don't actually think they could. Let's see, I'm that tall. The keys are about twice as tall. So, no, I can reach the top of this. Maybe this version of me has to jump. So past me, I'm gonna have to make a recording of me standing on top of this thing, and I'll probably have to jump. And then future me will have to be on top of me on top of another block, and they'll also have to jump, I think. So, step one here, I think, is how do I get this block? Okay, so I need to take this block, and it needs to be here. I need to let future me jump up, and then when future me is up there, I need to put the block on the floor so that I can jump up onto it from here. So I'll move the block over here, grab the platform, let future me jump on top. Future me hopefully has the ability to have a block up top. And then I'll run over here and I'll jump like cray cray, like so much cray cray that you don't even know, for reals. Important thing to test here is, can I take the block up the top with me? I usually can, yes. So future me will have a block, that's fine. So, guess we'll just get started. So, go get it, future me. You get up on top of that ledge. Yeah, I guess. I wonder if that platform's gonna be important or not. I don't know. Maybe the fact that you can hold it straight up might be important. I'll find out. So, I gave myself enough time, probably. Oh, right, I need to go pick myself up. Here, future me, get on. God, you're so slow, future me. What's taking so long? Is it because you have to carry a heavy-ass box for the 17th time in this game? They really put me through a lot of manual labor in this game, don't they? How rude of them. Lots of jumping, because that's the only thing I can think to do. Hopefully, that'll reach the key or something. I'm thinking maybe holding this platform up might help in some way, but probably not. I don't know. I mean, future me, of course. So, guess I'll just drop it. All right, so really quickly here. Grab this, hop up, put that down for some reason. Okay, so, ooh, almost dropped. So, I need to wait for future me, past me to go back and forth now. Past me has not figured out what to do yet. Hey idiot from a second ago, there we go. And you. I have no idea if this is gonna work, but it's my immediate solution at this point. From up here, it looks like my chances are better. It didn't look as good earlier. There we go. That was easy. Alright, so, open this up. Is that it? That's the whole solution? These aren't even very difficult puzzles, to be honest. I'm surprised. I wonder if the sixth floor is going to be completely insane, or if they're all going to be like this. By the way, there's this one patch on the wall, that one right there. It's bothering me, because every time I see it, I look at it, and I think I see a QR code, and that's not what it is. It's just a weird light patch in the metal. Yep. That's the gate triggering. Kind of a pointless gate this time because you can just casually walk in and out. But because it's open, that means I can walk out. So what I'm wondering, I'll get to the terminal in a second. What I'm wondering is if there's a cool advantage to being able to go out there. Oh wait, there's still a bubble here, right? Okay, so we can't go all the way out. I was wondering if we could take the, record ourselves with the platform over here and, like, just walk out here and let ourselves out somehow and be able to platform around crazy spots, but can't take anything out with us necessarily because of the purple. But you could conceivably have access to some weird shit around here if you could jump up properly. The question is there any reason to? Part of me wants to go up there to see if there's something cool up there. I keep looking for more crazy shit in the environment, probably specifically because of the fact that everything freaking is weirdly easy right now. Problem here is the fact that you can't... I don't know if you can carry someone through that doorway without them falling off. I mean, so... Can I get up there? That'd be cool. What if there's something really cool over there? Let's find out if I can carry myself with the platform or not. So. Oh, I just fucked up and moved the box all the way down there. That was a mistake. Shit. I'll just give myself a lot of time to try to get it, I guess. You got it? You got it, future me, maybe? I don't know. We'll find out. Is that enough room? I don't know. Find out. I just want to see if I can get out of here. Get out! Hop up! Leave! Leave! Get out of the puzzle! Escape! Escape, future me! Escape! Okay, that's the best I can do. Let's see if I can grab the butt. If I can grab it very quickly. Okay, drop. And. I fucked up and I left it, but I can almost make it back. I just need to make myself a quick staircase. Okay, yeah, there we go. So here it is, moment of truth. Can I fit? Oh, I don't know if I can fit. Why can't I crouch? Game, give me a crouch button. I'm gonna get scraped off, aren't I? Oh, wow, I fit. And I dramatically paused to emphasize the fact. So, here I go. I'm on top of the wall. Can I go out of here? I can. Do I gain access to something by coming out here, or is it just a cool trick? Oh no, is there nothing here? Come on, game, you gotta put something in here. Did they not plan on me coming out here? Is this me breaking the game? If I hop over that wall, am I gonna die? Is that gonna get me trapped and I'm gonna have to load a checkpoint? Whee! Now what, game? You all move, holy man. Oh, is that a way out? No, it's not. I may have just trapped myself. The game may not have planned on me getting in here. Oh no. Oh no, this is the first time. It's like this is my first time being smarter than the game. Up until now, they've always been outsmarting me, and it's always like, oh, I found a way to get over here. Oh, they planned on that all along. It was a trick. This time, not so much. I'm stuck. There's no way out. Fuck. See you guys in a bit. All right, I'm back, so let's just do some more reading and hopefully trigger a checkpoint before I do that, have to do all that again. So, now it's time to figure out the password to the next floor, if we can. Hopefully it's one of these text documents. So, sacred numbers. And so the blessed messenger revealed unto me the bones of New Jerusalem, slumbering in the dust that was the body of Adam, awaiting the day of resurrection, and lo and behold, within the dust was concealed a holy fire, and the fire, the sacred numbers, of which the one you seek is 748. 748. And I perceived that with the holy fire and the sacred knowledge and spirit sigils, the rekindling. Alright, so 748. Gotta keep that in mind. 748. I'm bad at remembering numbers. 748. Number 5. 748. 748. It's really weird to see the numbers laid out in that way. Like, I get it's kind of the numpad pattern, but it's weird that they're just in these massive horizontal bars. Makes them harder to read. But anyway, now we can read normally. I wonder, are these really weird... There's all these documents that have door codes in them that are nonsensical. I wonder, I think... Those must be being left by Shepard, right? They don't seem to fit the rest of the text. So it's like Shepard's just manually adding passwords into each document. If that's the case, why did that one have a post-it note but the other ones didn't? Maybe on that terminal it was also hidden inside of one of the text messages and I just didn't notice, but because it was also on a post-it note. Who knows? But 16, a second awakening in... So I think this is another chapter of... I think that's chapter 16 of Athena? Of Athena. The fires burned here, but beyond the incense, she could smell the cold wind from the kingdom of Artemis, where... Output error log text. But I am not Hephaestus, you see, for though I wield his hammer and know the secrets of his forge, I am not lame, and neither am I a god. Who are you then? They said. I wonder, these are especially corrupt pieces of text so far, is what it seems, with a lot less insight to be gathered from them in many cases. I wonder if this tower is supposed to be a dumping ground of broken stuff that Elohim has disposed of. Like the recycling bin, essentially. I don't know if anyone's ever going to read this, but if you do, if we succeeded, then I want you to know that Alexandra stayed until the last moment. I'm leaving. Too tired, too broken, desperate for a few moments of peace with my remaining loved ones, but she's still there, and she won't give up. And yes, there are thousands like her all over the world, giving humanity, giving everything because they believe in humanity. But she's the one that I know, as a real person, a colleague, a friend. I know that she likes peanut ice cream and hates strawberry. that her favorite band is Pink Floyd, and her favorite poet is Blake, and that her favorite TV show is Futurama. Lots of text. Studied at Cornell, and that her dad's name was Carl, and that her mom's name was a lot of hex digits. I don't know if I should be ashamed for leaving, but I know that I'm proud of her. She was the best of us. Remember her. So that's the last message about... That was, I would say, out of all the people we know, that was probably Nadia Sarabai? It's probably the last person we're hearing from here, if they're potentially one of the last people leaving that wasn't Alexandra, who dedicated everything to sticking around here. There's a lot of text here. Obviously, we have hex here, but there's also weird clumps of numbers up top that almost seem like they could be code in their own right, but maybe a code that I'm not even familiar with the existence of. I will say that these interjections of code, from the handful of times I've translated them so far, they didn't have anything to do with the surrounding text. Like, at first I always assumed that they were just like pieces of corrupting code and you just had to translate that bit and that would tell you the missing piece. But really, it's like someone interjected their own text into the middle of this text, but it's also corrupted. I mean, not corrupted, but it's in the wrong language. And so you get hidden messages that are completely context-free and just sort of floating there. So, here we go, guys. Look at all of this stuff we have. Now we have four floors of text. 18, 19, 20, 21. We are all the way up to time capsule 21. Only one we're missing is 16. Probably because I think there's one guardian, or whatever you call it, place I haven't been to yet. I might experiment a little. In fact, yeah, let's experiment a little before I move on. Record. Platform. Chillax for a moment here. Wait for future me to be all clever and shit and finish things. Alright. I just want to see if there's anything up here before I leave. Hit. That might not work because I might have needed to have put down a box first, but if that doesn't work, we'll see. Come on, quickly. Oh wait, I should be fine because I can hop on top of that one. Oh shit. Let me on. No! Okay. Wow, I made it. Oh, no. Got fucked. I'll be back in a minute here. All right, we're at this again, carefully avoiding the purple. All right. So I set myself up. I set the box up there in advance with the hopes being that, let's be quick here. I can't talk too much. There we go. Probably don't need this box. I don't know why it's with me. I'll take it with me just in case it comes in handy. Don't fall off. Man, there's a lot of places I could potentially jump off if I had the chance. Okay. Now I'm up here. What have I accomplished? Probably nothing. Nothing. I'm really bummed out by the lack of secrets around here. They created spots where you can clearly get around in a cool way. Let's see. What's interesting here is that I can let myself on this platform while carrying this box. I can't take it with me while I go through that doorway because it'll scrape me off if I'm standing on top of the box. But here, I could put the box on top of the platform that Future Me is holding and then hop on top, and then that could take me somewhere else. So I should look for even higher platforms I could potentially get to. Like on top of there. I get on top of that purple door area if I wanted to, but I don't see a reason to, unfortunately. Huh. More secrets. I go on top of there easily, but there's nothing there. Yeah, there's just no stars around here as far as I can tell. There's no reason to go further, which bothers me because I'm totally game for solving more of this area. But they just stopped making stuff, I guess. Kind of a bummer. All right, I guess we can go to floor 5 now. Right, I had to restore that one checkpoint, so I lost everything. Hopefully I don't see a blatant area where I need connectors, because I'll be bummed out for having to resolve floor 1. Although since it's complete, I can probably walk into the back door and just grab everything again. It's a beautiful sight, though.